I don't blame my family. I don't blame the people around me. But I do think it would have been a lot easier if I could have had a lot of help when I was younger. I think that very small part of me that is my mental illness could have been looked after a lot easier if I had had that time to accept it at a younger age. And I think a lot of people are in that situation.
I still to this day am more comfortable saying I'm a person struggling with a heroin addiction and an ex-convict than I am saying, you know what, I'm struggling daily with PTSD and bipolar.
Well, it doesn't matter whether I was dealing with depression or knew that I might have an onset. I'm not thrilled about the fact that not very many people knew, and the ones who did, I had such a hard time sometimes retaining their support.
People are still not comfortable about talking about having a mental illness. And it is this catch-22, because not enough other people are out, so you're not comfortable coming out about it.
I have heard time and time again, and again, this is research-based, that the stigma is worse than the illness. I think that there is a huge degree of fear for people coming out about having mental illness. And I think that some of that fear is really rooted in real things. I mean, people can be worried about keeping their jobs, or the healthcare providers will believe that they actually know what's going on for them. I think that's kind of the trap with mental illness, is if people know you have it, then people start to question everything that you say. And I think that can be really challenging for people.
When you're conditioned to believe that mental illness is a person's fault, then you have to unlearn that. And unlearning things is not easy. So it was something I really had to unlearn and had to accept. And that took a number of years before I was able to.
I think it would benefit everyone's mental health and well-being and physical wellness to have more acceptance and understanding in society for people's mental differences, rather than stigmatizing and saying that someone's ill simply because they have a different way of perceiving or walking in the world.
I know when I was struggling with my issues, I really longed for someone who had been through it. I think that we're afraid to tell our stories, but I think if we just opened up more, that would be huge.
I'm currently seeing a wellness worker, and she's gonna try and get me in with some, like, a native counselor, which I think would be good for me because most of them have been through this stuff. I've been through so many counselors, tons and tons of counselors, and it's pointless because they haven't been through it, they haven't experienced it, and they just sit there and they kind of just nod their head at you.
Doctors can empathize, but I think it's important for people who actually have walked in those shoes to help those who are just needing someone to model hope.
I believe people will be less hard on themselves if they have the understanding that it's not anything to be ashamed of, because shame can make you do some really stupid things.
I think one of the most damaging things about stigma is that it gets embedded inside of us. I think we can all relate to the idea of people not accepting us and then that becoming part of our identity. It's damaging.
Admitting that I needed help was probably one of the best things that saved my life, so definitely recommend sharing your story, and just even if you aren't sure how to articulate what you're trying to say, just to say I need help. I'm not even sure why, but I need help, and I'm scared, and what's this next step?